Hello friends, welcome to my channel Chemistry with SK. In today's session, we'll see the concept of electroplating. Mainly, electroplating is useful for corrosion prevention, but it has many applications, so we'll see in detail about the electroplating technique. Electroplating. First of all, you must write the principle of any concept. So the principle of this electroplating process, we have to write that this process is based on, this process of electroplating is based on the concept of electrolysis. On the concept of electrolysis, electrolysis process or electrolysis principle. So you know electrolysis, the main word is electrolysis here. So we'll see the method, how to perform this process, how there is a electroplating process. So we'll see the diagram. We have to take non-conducting plate, non-conducting jar. In that, suppose we are taking one anode. So suppose this is anode and we have to take a metal. Suppose we are taking one metal for electroplating. The benefit of this method is any shape metal can be taken for electrolysis. Suppose we are taking such a shape for the coating process, that is plating process, electroplating process. Remember that the electroplating is a type of metallic coating. What do you mean by metallic coating? A coating of one metal over another metal. That is, coating of one metal over another metal is called as metallic coating. This is called as base metal. It is the base metal on which we are giving the coating. While the upper metal whose coating is given, that is called as coating metal. The base metal is also called as coated metal. So this is acting as anode. Actually, this is the coating metal. This is acting as cathode. Okay, this is acting as anode and this is acting as cathode. This is called as base metal. It is connected. As it is electrolysis process, it means we have to connect, we have to supply electricity. Now, whenever you are using battery in any connection, in any diagram, you must remember that the connections, proper connections, as the positive and negative both parts are to be written somewhere. So, in such cases, I always suggest my students that ye dono dhyan mein rakhne ke bajaye ek hi dhyan mein rakho. It means, what happens? We are memorizing, negative terminal is connected to the so-and-so and positive to so-and-so. But when we, afterwards, if we forget, then we get in confusion. Therefore, my suggestion is always that you should remember only one thing, either of these two. Suppose, as you are using battery, here the positive terminal of battery is connected to the coating metal, that is anode, and negative terminal of battery is connected to the base metal. Coating metal is connected to positive terminal of battery and negative terminal of battery is connected to the base metal. Here, the electrolytic solution which is present, suppose it is electrolytic solution. The electrolytic solution which is available here, that is the solution of salt of coating metal. It is the electrolyte solution of, it is the salt of coating metal. CM, not chief minister. It is coating metal. So, it is the salt of coating metal. Now, what happens? We'll see the process. Concentrate properly. What happens? This is anode. It has tendency to pass into solution. So, this metal will pass into solution in the form of metal plus ions. Metal positive charges. Metal cations will be formed and large number of such metal positive ions or metal cations will be released into solution, and this electrolyte solution will consist of metal ions which are given by the anode. Same metal ions are already present there in the form of its own salt solution. Still, there is no change in concentration of the salt solution of this electrolyte. So what will happen? The metal ions will pass into solution and electrons will be liberated on this anode. These electrons will be shifted from this circuit to the cathode, and now electrons will be available on cathode here. Now I will remove these electrons because these electrons are coming on the cathode, so electrons are available here. As electrons are available here, due to opposite charge or due to electrostatic force of attraction, all the metal ions present in the solution that will be attracted towards cathode, that is towards this base metal which is acting as cathode, and there will be demand for electron. All these metals will demand for electron, so there will be, the electrons will be given and there will be deposition of this metal on the cathode. So the metal ions will deposit on this cathode by gain of electron, and there will be a coating, a strong coating will be developed on the cathode, and this is nothing but the electroplating. So we'll see the reactions, which reactions are taking place here. So we'll see the reactions. Firstly, we'll see the reaction which is taking place on anode. Actually, we can take any metal. Suppose we are taking copper. Then copper metal, which is acting as anode here, that will pass into solution in the form of copper 2 plus ions or copper 1 plus ions. Suppose there is a loss of electron, 2 electrons are lost, and there is formation of copper 2 plus ions. Another element or another metal we can consider. If there is a silver, then silver will become silver plus ion by loss of 1 electron. Now what reaction will take place on cathode? So the cathodic reaction will be the copper plus ions, copper 2 plus ions, which will be formed here inside the electrolyte, that will gain electrons, and there is formation of neutral copper, and it gets deposited on the cathode. Or if there is a silver, then silver ions will gain electron, and that will become neutral silver, and it will also deposit on the base metal which is acting as cathode. So in this way the reactions can be written. So the principle, it is based on electrolysis principle, the process. Here one thing we should remember, that there is no change in the concentration of salt solution or electrolytic solution, though these ions are released. Though this metal, coating metal, is releasing some ions in the solution, still there is no change in concentration, because the same quantity of ions which are getting deposited on the cathode, and that's why there is no change in the concentration of this electrolyte. One more thing, as this metal, coating metal, is passing into solution, it means there is a decrease in mass of this coating metal. There is a decrease in weight of this anode, and that will be equal to, it means the loss in weight of the anode will be exactly equal to increase in weight of cathode. Okay, and one more thing, if this anode is impure, if this coating metal is impure, then the impurities will settle down at the bottom of this jar, bottom of this container, in the form of mud. But the, if the metal is pure, then the loss in weight and gain in weight will be equal, and it is about the electroplating process. Now we'll see the applications. The applications of electroplating. mainly the electroplating is used for corrosion prevention. That is the main application, corrosion prevention. Second is for decoration and for better look, we can say decoration of various metallic articles. So the third application may be, it is useful in the making ornaments, especially gold polish ornaments, plated or reform ornaments. Electro reforming of many machinery parts. Electro reforming of machinery parts. Machinery parts. So these are some of the applications, main applications of electroplating. Electro reforming of many machinery parts where the corrosion is expected. If these are electroplated parts of the machine, then there will be better corrosion prevention. So it is also useful in the electro reforming of machine parts. So that's it. It is about the electroplating.